And David Grindley, now 19 years old, the new British record holder, is talking to Brendan Foster.
David, I'm going to tell you something you don't know. The new British record holder, 44.47.
British? I can't believe it. I can't believe it. Oh, I don't know where that's come from. I haven't a clue where that has come from.
It didn't come without some hard work, though, did it?
No, I'm really tired, to say the least. Well, done my job and made the final. That's what I came to do. Just got to try my best in the final now.
That, when I told you you were the new British record holder, that was supposed to lift you. You were supposed to be pleased with that.
I'm too tired. No. Oh, brilliant. I can't express my feelings properly.
Congratulations, David. That was fantastic.
Thanks. Thanks. Thank you.
All night for Wigan. Phyllis Smith becomes the second fastest British woman of all time in the 400 to the Olympic final. Now Grindley, only 19, also from Wigan. The Wigan club goes into the final with a new British record, and that's confirmed. Quincy Watts, a new Olympic record. Lee Evans' old record set at Mexico City at altitude way back in 1968. Samson Couture, Kenyan, in second place. Ian Morris of Trinidad, third. David Grindley, fourth. The new British record at 44.47. And Roger Black, obviously with problems, but still a very fast time indeed, at 44.72 in fifth place and doesn't make the Olympic final. It's just come too soon for him. He's been struggling on and off for about 5 weeks, and the problem has not quite been solved. On the way into the stadium now for the next event but one, the finalists in the 110-metre hurdles. That's Jarrett and Huey Teep. Here's Jarrett of Haringey, Huey Teep of Enfield, into the final. And of course, we've got all three Britons through. But the Americans are looking good. The long walk, and they go into the shade and into the covered track area beneath the Olympic Arena. Colin Jackson walking by himself. The British number one set the fastest time in these Olympic Games yesterday morning in the first round, 13.10, but a couple of by his standards in different runs. And although he hit two or three hurdles when beaten by McCoy in the semi-final, he still clocked 13.19. so that final, the 110 meter hurdles, comes at 7:15. The next event on the track after the start, well, it starts at 5:05, will be the women's 800 meters final.